Hello.
Hello friends, I trust you're having a nice time. Welcome to today's video lesson. Our topic today is idioms. Okay, idioms. So let's go right into the lesson. Idiom is an expression that does not mean what it says word for word. So an idiom is an expression. It's like a sentence that does not mean what it says word for word. Let's see this example. Which picture tells the meaning of the idiom, it rained cat and dog? Is it picture A or picture B? It rained cat and dog. Of course, it's picture B. So when someone says it rained cat and dog, it doesn't mean live cats and live dogs fell from the sky as rain. The person is trying to say it rained heavily, the weather was stormy, there was lightning and thunderstorms. Alright? So, it rained cat and dog is an idiom. It's an expression, but it doesn't mean what it says, word for word. Let's see another example. Which picture tells the meaning of the idiom, to cut corner? Is it picture A or picture B? To cut corner. Of course, it's picture A. So cut corner means to look for an easy way out, a cheaper way out, or a wrong way out. So the boy on orange is looking for an easier way to pass his test. He doesn't want to work hard to read so that he could write his test himself. He's looking for a cheaper way out, a cheaper way to pass his test. So A is the correct answer. When someone says to cut corner, he or she doesn't mean you will need to take a piece of paper and start cutting the corners of that paper. No. Now, which option tells the meaning of the idiom, curiosity kills the cat? Is it A, a cat will die when it is eager to know something? Or B, being too worried to know something can get one into trouble? So when someone says curiosity kills the cat, what option best tells the meaning of the idiom? Of course it's B. Curiosity means you're too eager, you want to know, you want to know, you want to know, you want to know. That's curiosity. And you want to know to the point that you're doing so many things so that you will know. That could get you into trouble. For instance, you want to know things about your neighbors, things that don't concern you, it's not your business, but you want to poke nose into their matter. That type of attitude could get you into trouble. So when one says curiosity kills the cat, they are saying being too worried to know something can get you into trouble. Which option tells the meaning of the idiom, it cost an arm and a leg? Does it mean you will need to pay using your arm and leg, or it's too expensive? What do you think? Of course, it's too expensive. So if you walk into a store and you want to buy a cold drink and they tell you it costs an arm and a leg, they are not saying you should remove your arm and your leg and give it to them. They are only trying to tell you it's too expensive. Alright? Which picture tells the meaning of the idiom? So let's see the pictures. Root kids are two peas in a pod. They aren't twins, but they look and act like they are. So the idiom is two peas in a pod. Which picture tells the meaning of that idiom? Of course, the second picture. Now, the expression two peas in a pod is actually referring to Root's children. Okay, and they said they are not twins. They look alike. Yes, if you look at the picture, you will notice they look alike and they act like they are. Of course, if you notice their hair, they packed their hair the same way, they act like they are twins. The expression two peas in a pod doesn't mean that they are green peas that we use to cook fried rice. No, no, no. Let's try out this example together. Which picture tells the meaning of the idiom? Let's see the pictures. Cody has a sweet tooth, so he wants more chocolate cake. And the idiom is has a sweet tooth. course, is the first one. When they say someone has a sweet tooth, it means the person loves to eat sweet things. It doesn't mean he has a sweet tooth that is so nice that brings him flowers every time. Which picture tells the meaning of the idiom, we want to buy a big dog? Okay, let's see the pictures. We want to buy a big dog, but Dad isn't sure. He says he will sleep on it and tell us tomorrow. And the idiomatic expression is sleep on it. So which picture explains the meaning sleep on it? So which picture explains the meaning of the idiom sleep on it? Of course, it's the second. So when someone says I will sleep on it, it means I will think about it. So they told their dad they wanted a big dog, and the dad isn't sure if he wants to get a big dog, but he's telling them, don't worry, I'm going to sleep on it, I will think about it, and I'll get back to you by tomorrow. We've come to the end of today's lesson, so I want you to read the idioms that are in black and match them to their meanings in red. See you in my next video class. Bye!